Welcome to this old film look effect tutorial. I'm in new DaVinci Resolve project. We'll start by importing a media to the timeline. I have this boat MP4 video downloaded from pexels.com. When prompted to change the frame rate, hit don't change as we'll leave it to the original frame rate. Now drag the clip to the timeline. Let's quickly play it to see what we got. We got a boat calmly sailing across the sea. We'll convert this to a fusion clip. So right click on the video in the timeline and select new fusion clip. Now we can move to the fusion page. Close the spline window by hitting the spline button on the top of the screen. Now I want to have only one screen because that is all we need to see. Make the screen bigger so that we have a better look. Now with media in one selected, hit Ctrl space and search for film damage node. And add it to the screen. Move to the film damage settings page and let's do some adjustments. We start with changing the film blur. I type 0.19. Now move to the temperature shift. And give it a value of 0.84. Change the tint shift to minus 0.17. Now move to the head vignetting part, there we have a focal factor, geometry factor, tilt amount and tilt angle. Let's see what the focal factor does. Okay, roll back to its original value. We'll just change the geometry factor. Now scroll down, leave the dirt color to black, change dirt density to 4, leave dirt size unchanged, change the dirt blur to 0.4. And leave the seed unchanged. The dirt are those black dots in the screen that give an old film look effect to the video. Let's quickly adjust the dirt density so you can see better those black dots. We returned the old value. Go to the add scratch one section. Scratches this black line over the video to see it better. We can change its width. I change the scratch position to 0.504. There are many other settings to the scratch, but in this video we will change only few of them. Go to moving amplitude and change it to 0.134. change moving speed. To 3.169. Moving randomization. To somewhere 0.724. And flickering speed to 1.02. Let's play to see what we got so far. We get a nice old film look. Now go and select the film damage node, hit Control Space and search for flicker addition. As you can see, it gives a nice video flickering effect. In the flicker type drop-down, select flicker vignette. Change the range. Give it a value of 0.071. Quickly see the speed and smoothness effects, but I'll return those to their original value. Let's see the flicker quality settings. I leave them all to their original state. We will only change the flicker vignette and the range values. Now back to the notes section. With flicker edition notes selected, hit Control Space and search for camera shake node. This gives a nice camera shaking effect. In our video, it looks like the video is being recorded from another boat, shaken by the sea waves. Let's edit the settings. Change motion scale to 0.205. Speed scale to 0.598. Leave the motion blur to the original value. In the shake level section, we will only change the tilt amplitude and PTR speed. And finally, we add a TV node. In this node, we change the scan lines to 0 and the frequency to 8.43. Now let's see the other settings quickly. In this settings section, we will only change the scan lines and the frequency. Now move to the noise settings page. Change the size to 0.354. And the random 2.29 for now. In the roll bar page, change the bar strength to 0.1. Leave the bar size to the original value and change the bar offset to a value just to see its effect. Now, to make this video look like it is being watched on an old TV, we will animate the bar offset. Go to frame 1 of the video, right click and animate next to the bar offset, play the video. And as the video is playing, we move the slider. This white vertical bars tell us that keyframes are being added to the video. Now quickly I add some more keyframes. And this is enough for the purpose of this video. If we play the video, we now see those horizontal bars moving up and down. The TV node might not be necessary. I've added it just so you can see what you can achieve with it. As a last thing, I will animate the noise randomness. Right click next to the random slider and select modify width and hit shake. If we zoom, you can see those noise dots changing randomly to give an even better old TV, old film effect. Finally, we move to the edit page, move to the beginning of the video and play it. And here we are in the end of this video that showed you how to create an old film look in DaVinci Resolve. We used nodes like film damage, flicker animation, camera shake and TV node to achieve this effect. I hope you can use something from what you learned in your next projects. Thanks for watching.